up Bernard? Bernard Sander. Going on live television. This is not live, but he was on ABC this week, and Bernard Sander has some really choice words for President Joe Manchin. And I just want to say this is the Bernard Sander that we need to see everywhere. I know Bernard loves to like play patty cake. In my opinion, he plays too much patty cake. This is the Bernard Sander. This is how Bernard should be talking about Joe Biden, Kamala Harris, Nancy Pelosi, and Chuck Schumer as well. This is the good Bernard Sander. Let's watch.
And the agenda there. Senator Joe Manchin, of course, abruptly pulled the plug this week on the Democrats.
No, Martha, he didn't abruptly. Martha.
Okay.
So real quick, before we get in here, the way that these political events that happen are sanitized by the media is by wording. It's like a game of telephone, right? So the media says, oh, it's abrupt. When I first covered this, I was like, this literally looks like a headline from July 2021. It's not abrupt, right? When you can, it's like if you throw a fucking ball at the wall and then say the ball abruptly bounced off the wall. There's nothing abrupt about it. It's like if I were to turn this cup upside down and then say water abruptly fell from the cup. No. I turned it upside down. That's literally what happens. It's cause and effect. It's you look at what's going to, like you look at what the setup and then you're not surprised at the outcome. So again, picking apart language in the media especially, that's what I like to consider that to be one of my things that I love to do. I love picking apart language. And this is exactly what Bernie is doing here, and that's why I appreciate this so much.
He didn't abruptly, Martha.
He abruptly on Friday.
He didn't abruptly do anything.
He was negotiating for a while.
He has sabotaged the president's agenda. No. Look, if you check the record 6 months ago, I made it clear that you have people like Manchin, Sinema to a lesser degree, who are intentionally sabotaging the president's agenda, what the American people...
Like, the idea that the media somehow is... The same media that did the Trump lie trackers somehow believe that no other politician can lie? So the idea that Joe Manchin might say, oh yeah, I'll support this and not that and this and that, and then 2 weeks later saying, ah, fuck the whole thing. But they just think, oh, he was negotiating. Was he? No, he was lying. And you dumb motherfuckers believed him. And that's what's important about this pushback from Bernard Sander.
People want what a majority of us in the Democratic caucus want. Nothing new about this. And the problem was that we continue to talk to Manchin like he was serious. He was not. This is a guy who is a major recipient of fossil fuel money, a guy who has received campaign contributions from 25 Republican billionaires.
Senator, you say he wasn't serious, but Manchin says his main goal is to do what's good for West.
You say that Joe Manchin was a liar, but Joe Manchin said, I am not a liar. So, you don't, okay. So someone, the claim is that someone's a liar. And if they say, I'm not a liar, that's not disproving the claim. Because if they were a liar, of course they would say, I'm not a liar. Because if they're okay with lying, then they're going to say whatever they need to say in order to advance their political agenda. This idea, again, that Joe Manchin can never lie. It's impossible. He'll never lie. He's incapable of lying. He's a great person.
Virginia, and he's worried about inflation. Listen to what he told the West Virginia radio station. Listen to this, please.
Is that right?
They cut him off! They cut him off! Oh!
His main goal is to do what's good for West Virginia, and he's worried about inflation. Listen to what he told the West Virginia radio station. Listen to this, please.
Is that right?
Inflation is absolutely killing many, many people. They can't buy gasoline. They have a hard time buying groceries. Everything they buy and consume for their daily lives is a hardship to them.
Your reaction to that, Senator?
Well, look, the same nonsense that Manchin has been talking about for a year. West Virginia, it's a beautiful state. I've had the pleasure of being there. Great people. It is one of the poorest states in this country. You ask the people of West Virginia whether they want to expand Medicare to cover dental, hearing, and eyeglasses. You ask the people of West Virginia whether we should demand that the wealthiest people and large corporations start paying their fair share of taxes. Ask the people of West Virginia whether or not all people should have health care as a human right like in every other country on earth. That's what they will say. In my humble opinion, you know, Manchin represents the very wealthiest people in this country, not working families in West Virginia or America.
And Senator Sanders, I want to end with, if these provisions don't get passed, doesn't look like they will, what does that mean for Democrats' climate goals and the climate itself?
Martha, it ain't Democrats. It isn't the president. It is the future of the planet. So when-
I got to find the rest of this clip, but goddamn. That's the Bernard that we need. That is the Bernard that just it it's just, I mean, again, the language abrupt, right? That's how, because people don't have bullshit detectors in this country. People don't know how to look at something and then go like, "Oh, that's bullshit." Right? So the media takes advantage of that. The cops take advantage of that. That's why they lie about it. Oh, there's a... Remember, George Floyd, when he was murdered by the police, the original police press release was like, someone... A man died of a medical incident and the cops tried to render aid. Right? But then people read that and they go like, oh, yeah, okay. It's ludicrous. It's ludicrous. I really need you to understand... These people are liars. They are liars and freaks. And so this is the kind of Bernard that we need to... Like, when Bernard does this kind of shit, we need to be very positive about it, and we need to get him to do this more. And he should have done this in that March debate with Joe Biden in 2020. Remember that weird-ass debate that was, like, during the... You know, the first COVID debate when Joe Biden was... Remember when Joe Biden was one of those weird anti-COVID people and he was telling people, go vote in person. COVID's not real. Remember? Joe Biden said that. Simone Sanders, not related to Bernie Sanders. Simone Sanders, Joe Biden's press person during the campaign, said, go vote in person during the height of the first coronavirus wave, right? But then all of a sudden now, like, you know, that I want that to really... inform your opinion on how Joe Biden's handling COVID now, because he's gone back to that position. When he was going up against Trump, COVID, we're going to fight COVID, we're going to win against COVID. And then as soon as he won the election, he went right back to what he was doing before that during the primary. And again, Bernie Sanders had an opportunity to point that out, and he didn't. And that's a problem. But this, again, this is the Bernard that we need. Just anywhere and everywhere. I mean, the time for patty cake with these people, I think, is long, long past us. But anyway, there you go. That's Bernard. Got that Bernard Sanders.